What's going on, everybody? We are back with a brand new episode of the Daily Grossi. It is Wednesday, October 9th. We are here with the general of the 100 Years War. We just watched the Guardians drop a playoff game, so sorry if our moods are sour. But, Tony, let's talk some Browns.
That'll brighten everybody up.
Yeah. Tony, hey, we're all depressed. Let's talk about the Browns.
Well,
let's start with the injuries, Tony, because there was a lot in a lot of roster shuffling. Let's get to that.
First of all, they put the long snapper on injured reserve.
How does a long snapper get hurt? I just have to ask you.
It's a rib injury, and Kevin described it as a friendly fire. So someone got knocked into him or something on one of the special teams plays. Okay. So they brought back the local kid, Rex Sunahara, I believe. Mm-hmm. Sunahara. Yep. He'll be the long snapper at least for the next four games. Okay, here's the guys who did not practice. Amari Cooper was just rest. Grant Delpit has a concussion. He did not practice. They designated for a return two guys from IR, which means they're able to start practicing. Wait a minute. Let me get to that later. Guys who didn't practice include Deontay Foreman with an ankle. Miles Garrett, Achilles, his Wednesday rest day. Mm-hmm. Ronnie Hickman, ankle injury, did not practice. James Hudson still out with the shoulder. Njoku did not practice, knee and ankle. The ankle was the high ankle, but now he's got a knee injury. Ethan Posick, the center, knee, did not practice. And Denzel Ward with that hamstring did not practice. Just to note, Jack Conklin was limited, and so was Jedrick Wills. So the two tackles are still trying to get into it. Wills played the game. He should be okay by now. They designated two guys on IR to return to practice. They were the linebacker, Mahmoud Diabate. And who's the other one? I'm looking.
Mo Hurst was the other one, Tony.
Maurice Hurst, right. Jordan Hicks was limited. Naheem Hines and Nick Chubb were limited. So long injury list, but par for the course.
Yeah, especially on these Wednesdays, we become kind of accustomed to that with vet days off, all that kind of stuff. All right, Tony, the big news of the day, I think, other than that, was Stefanski talked, Watson talked. What did you hear from each of them? What is anything changing? Are we getting to the point where, what are they doing? Just run us through it.
Yeah, you know, again, I asked the coach directly, are you going to change your play calling operations? And he said, no, I'm comfortable with the collaboration we're getting on the headsets, and we're going to continue to do it that way. Now, what that means, I don't know. It kind of indicated maybe he'll listen more, I don't know, to Ken Dorsey, or maybe it'll come out later on during the week or even during the game. Mm-hmm. That is calling plays, but the coach would not confirm that.
So what does that mean, Tony? Collaboration of the plays. What does that mean?
Instead of simplifying it, it sounds like it complicates it, you know, with others contributing in the headset. And of course, Stefanski would be the one mouthing the plays to Watson. Mm-hmm. But it just sounds like everyone is going to suggest something at the given time. We'll see how it works. Or maybe that was just a word salad, and maybe there will be more responsibility for Dorsey. We might be able to detect it on the telecast of the game. Mm-hmm. You know, if Stefanski is not covering his mouth with that play sheet, I'm sure he'll have the play sheet in his hand. But so far, so then I bounced it off of Watson. I said, hey, listen, you told me on Sunday, ask Kevin about this, and I did, and he says no change. And then Watson went into this defense of Kevin, endorsing him and saying, we have complete faith in Kevin as a play caller. He's been the two-time coach of the year as a play caller. He's one of the best in the league. And we just have to I think Watson said something like, I just, as the quarterback, have to get us to execute on game days and make his plays look good. So that's where they stood on that issue today. And yet, Kevin and Watson both said, in answer to my question, are you changing anything? You know, this is the definition of insanity to keep doing everything the same. And they both indicated there are changes, but they wouldn't go into them. So we'll see Sunday.
Yeah, and then, Tony, I think you all – maybe you asked this. It was tough to hear, but it was on Sunday, Watson was like, we have to figure out what we do well, what we do good. Yeah. That kind of, you asked him about that. What did he say?
He said basically they're still trying to figure out what they do well and simplify things. He indicated they got to simplify things.
Mm-hmm.
And on Sunday night, Sunday night after the game, he further talked about running the ball more. So nothing definitive today, although there's something they're changing, apparently, but not willing to explain what it is.
Do you think this is going to be something that we can notice with the first snap? Because, like, when you go back to the Jacksonville game, Tony, right from the first snap, we're like, oh, this is different from week one. Do you think it's going to be like that?
I don't know. I asked them. I asked Deshaun directly. I said, the Greenbrier, we saw a lot of up-tempo stuff in the first week of installation. Where has that been? And he kind of agreed that, they got to get that first down before they could go into
which
that.
They don't get.
Although they did it at the first play in Washington, the 15-yard completion to Njoku.
Yeah.
But they didn't go into hurry up or up-tempo. Mm-hmm. But when I asked him about going up-tempo, his demeanor seemed to agree that that's what he likes, and maybe we'll see more of it. I asked them, is that you're not doing it because there's so many mistakes, you can't get into a rhythm? And pretty much admitted that's been the case too with, all the penalties. You can't get into a up-tempo when you're first and 15. You just can't.
Yeah. The big story, I think, is going to be Chubb, but we're not going to know anything about Chubb right now until
I don't see him being ready for this game. He still has not practiced with the full team period, and that I don't think that's happening this week. Next week they come home. It's Cincinnati. It's a grass field. I would think that they'll have to make a decision next week. The 21-day window will be up. Yeah. So, I mean, they'll put him on the active. It doesn't mean you have to play him after 21 days. You just have to put him on the active roster, and I'm sure they'll do that. Same thing with Nyheim Hines, I suppose.
For sure. All right, as we wrap up here, Tony, they have the worst offense in the NFL. There's a lot of people calling for Deshaun to get benched nationally, not as much locally, nationally, fans, whatever. They have one more away game, and they have three home games. At this point, do you think they're going into it like, we just have to win? Like, no matter what, we just have to figure out a way to win games? Like, do you think that's the change?
Well, I think that's always been the case, that they've had that attitude.
Mm-hmm. Go back to the Jacksonville game where they were like, hey, we're going to make stylistic changes to kind of help us just win games and we'll go from there,
Yeah, and remember, it worked that game, and then the next week they used these tight ends off the street as their, quote, tight ends.
Yeah.
And we didn't see any Nick Harris in the backfield.
Yeah.
So I don't know if that's the formula for just winning against every opponent, but we haven't seen it, you're right, since Jacksonville. I just don't know. I sense a frustration, and maybe I'm reading too much into it, but Jerry Jeudy, Elijah Moore, Cooper, to some degree, we'll listen to him tomorrow. But, receivers want the ball, and they want completions, and they want receptions and touchdowns, and it's just not happening.
Yeah. Anything else? I mean, obviously, the Wednesday injury report, Tony, is like, we see it, and then we get more definitive as the week goes on. So what else should we look for this week as we hear from the coordinators and as we see, the injury updates?
Yeah, well, I think, the big question is Njoku going to be ready?
Okay.
I think we could pencil in Miles, of course, and Jordan Hicks, who was limited, got back on the field and was limited today, looking at the injury report. Again, the question on Conklin,
Yeah.
They could really use him at right tackle right now.
Yeah.
And he's, He's still listed with the hamstring. It's no longer the knee. It's a hamstring. Yeah. So that would really be a lift, I think, if Njoku and Conklin can get in there. Njoku was very limited in the game Sunday and because he got hurt again. And he was on an obvious pitch count to begin that game anyway. So we'll see. This is week six. Mm-hmm. And three reports over a dozen players. I mean, that's not good. Whereas we know the Eagles coming off their bye are totally healthy. All the guys on their injury list had full participation except one, Nakobe Dean, the linebacker, who was limited. So they're getting their main guys back, including Lane Johnson, A.J. Smith, and Devonta Smith and A.J. Brown.
Yeah, definitely. Well, okay, Tony. Safe to say it's a must-win Sunday in Philly for the Browns. Hopefully, well, we're going to have another must-win because tomorrow's a must-win for the Guards now, too. So
now that is a true must-win.
That is an actual, like,
you're done. Elimination game right there, yeah.
Yeah.
And just think, if they win that, they get to go against Detroit's ace the next game. But it'll be in Cleveland.
It will be in Cleveland and could be at the same time as Oregon, Ohio State, Tony, which I know you probably have circled on your Saturday night plans.
Really? Yeah, I do want to see the Oregon quarterback play.
Yeah. So, all right, Tony, thank you so much. We will check in with you later this week as you go back to Berea and all that, and we'll talk to you soon.
Sounds good. See you then, Zach.